MVC is the go-to architecture for UIKit-based projects, and MVVM for SwiftUI ones. But is MVVM really the best choice for SwiftUI projects? Well, today I'm here to tell you that it is not. And in this video, I'm going to show you why MVC is the absolute best architecture for SwiftUI. Let's see why. Yes, MVC in SwiftUI. Now, let me get this clear. It's not model view controller, it's model view and controller. So you want to make sure that there's a distinction, and MVC with model view controllers for UIKit, and MVC is for model view and controller is for SwiftUI. And today I'm going to show you how all of this works. And if you want a 60-minute Zoom call, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me, where we can discuss these, and also if you want to learn SwiftUI, I'm available. Now, I have created a brand new Xcode project, and today I'm going to show you how MVVM kind of is supposed to work with SwiftUI and why it's not ideal for SwiftUI projects. And then we are going to dive into MVC and how it's like amazing for SwiftUI projects. So we have our content view. And what is MVVM? Let's start with MVVM. MVVM is kind of what Apple is suggesting in their documentation, and all the tutorials are kind of MVVM based. It kind of works with SwiftUI, but once you get a hold of it and once you try to implement it in real world applications, you will see its flaws. And today I'm going to highlight some of them. So MVVM is for model view view model. So we have a model layer, a view, and a view model layer which takes care of the logic and all of that stuff. So let's have an example here with a content view. Let's have here a text field so we can, you know, just create a real a live version of it. We're going to have a text field, title and key. Let's have name right over here, and we need to bind it somewhere. So usually we just go and have state right over here, private var name, and default value is an empty string. Let's bind it right over here, name, and also let's have here a text field style of rounded border because I prefer that. And let's build them well. Unlock your full iOS development potential with rebeloper.com/mentoring. My mentoring program is your ticket to mastering SwiftUI and conquering code debugging challenges. Whether you're a beginner looking to build a strong foundation or an experienced developer seeking to enhance your skills, I'm here to guide you every step of the way. Don't miss out on this opportunity to accelerate your iOS development journey. Visit rebeloper.com/mentoring today and take the first step toward becoming a SwiftUI pro. Here we are. If we add in here, either, okay, maybe we want to add our name variable right over here, so we want to make sure that that state variable actually holds that text field's text. Let's just see this. There we go. It works. This is only on the view. It is not model view controller. No MVVM. No MVVM just for now. So let's create a model. New file. Let's have a Swift file. Next. Profile, which will hold the name. So let's import SwiftUI over here. This will be a struct of profile and var name of type string. Yeah, we didn't even need to import SwiftUI. Foundation would be okay, but yeah, you most probably are going to make it identifiable or whatever, and that needs SwiftUI. So we have our profile right over here. So that's our model. This is our view. And then we need a view model. So, well, actually, let's have a profile right over here. So we just start off profile, and that is a profile with an empty string name. And then we are going to bind, first of all, let's have our text of profile.name. And now we are binding it just like that. And let's build and run and see how this works. So this is with the model and view. As you can see, the state is on the view itself. So let me just see if this is working. Great. If we want to add a view model, then we want to create it. Well, I've been doing videos on this several times, but the gist of it is that you want to make a view model that is available only on the content view. It's not, you should not have it as a view model for other views. It's a view model. So the content views view model. Therefore, I always suggest to have this as a file private class of view model right over there, and this would be an observable, and right over here we would just have our profile. Just go over there, and also now we can just have this as an environment. Let's just have, well, actually a state, because we are initializing that view model only for this view. So state private var, let's have our view model. We're going to talk about environments in just a second. So view model equals our view model. There we go. We initialized it, and then we're going to grab its profile just like that. And basically, let's build and run and see how this looks like. Build has succeeded. Let's type it in. Hello, Ada. It works as expected. Okay, so now what we did is basically have a view, a model, M, view, V, and view model, VM. So MVVM. Now, this is kind of okay, because we separated our properties right over here for the profile, but actually it's an extra step. We don't really need this. We don't need the view model. We can set it up as a state like we did with the profile, and then just have access to it. Anyway, the view model should have properties only that are accessible or need to be accessible on the content view itself only. Therefore, setting it up right over here on the view itself is really, really a good thing. Also, you might argue that we would have some functions right over here in the view model that take care of business logic. Well, you could have all of those functions right on the content view, of course. Now, great, this is fine. View model, MVVM, but it's kind of not SwiftUI like. It doesn't taste like SwiftUI. We have this extra step of creating our view model. So what I suggest, and this profile is available only on the content view. Maybe you want it available throughout your application. So what I suggest is MVC. So let's dive into MVC and what are the differences between the MVVM approach and MVC. And MVC stands for Model View and Controller. It's not View Controller again, I repeat that, it's Model View and Controller. So this profile, you usually want to use it in other ways, other views too. So we want to have it available throughout our code or through a subset of our views. In our case, I'm just going to let it be available throughout our code. Therefore, I'm not going to make this file private. So let's remove the file private, because I want this to be available throughout my project. And I'm not going to name it view model, because it's not the content view's view model. I'm going to name this, let's just have a profile, or let's just call this user controller. And you see, this is where the controller comes in. We have a user controller right over here, and it has the profile. Now, let me just, we are going to set up the user controller first, but we want to move this into a new file. Swift file, user controller, and let's move all of this into our user controller file. And of course, you need to import SwiftUI because the observable framework is part of SwiftUI, so you want to add that over there. Great. Now, how can we access our user controller inside our content view? Well, we are going to set it up on the content view itself, so on the main view of our application right over here, as at state private var user controller equals user controller, there we go. And then we are going to set it up as an environment. We are going to use the environment, this one, not the environment object or with the one with the key path, just environment. Let's go user controller. There we go. Now we have set that up as an environment. Therefore, on the content view or all of its subviews, and if we just add also some navigation, it will be available for us. So how do we access it? Well, through the environment view a property wrapper environment. We want to give a key path, right? Well, actually not a key path, but the name. So user controller dot self, and that will be var user controller. Okay, so we have our user controller. So how do we put them in, put the data into a text and the text field? Well, we just go user controller instead of view model, user controller profile dot name. That's fine. But what if, what about this binding on the text of the text field? Well, if you add at user controller.profile, it will say that it cannot actually, well, cannot find dollar sign user controller in scope. So we cannot make a binding of this environment. So there's a quick fix for this. We are going, instead of the dollar sign, so we are not binding it, we are just going to say bindable, open parentheses and close parentheses inside the user controller. So you are making the user controller a bindable, and then you just go dot profile dot name, no dollar sign required. So now just build and run, and let's see how this looks like. Of course, it should work as expected. And let's just test this out. So build has succeeded. That's great. Let's wait for this and type in Ada. There we go. Same as previously, but now we have our model, we have our view, we have our controller. And here you can add up business logic and all of that stuff. Of course, you want to set this up as an environment. And that is MVC, a much simpler way of doing things, much more SwiftUI-like, in my opinion. And of course, it already uses SwiftUI 5's observable framework. It's really, really nice. And that is the difference between MVVM and MVC, and I highly encourage you to use MVC in SwiftUI projects. And if you are curious why you should not use Spacer in a SwiftUI project, go ahead and check it out. The video is right over here.